The second option is what we call an experimental study. Hidden in this one sentence are aspects that are universal to all experimental studies we do in psychology. Let's start with caffeine in varying amounts. Every experiment we do, we have to manipulate or change something, or else we cannot make a causal statement from our results. So whatever it is that we manipulate or change is our independent variable. So in this case, caffeine is our independent variable, or IV for short, because we're changing the amount of caffeine each group gets. An easy way to remember this is investigator starts with an I, and independent variable also starts with an I, and it's the investigator that manipulates the independent variable. And we measure the effect of our independent variable on the dependent variable. The dependent variable in our experiment is reaction time, because the dependent variable is what we measure. We need to measure how the dependent variable responds or changes to the independent variable. So how does reaction time change when we manipulate caffeine? In order to make a causal statement, we need to make sure that the IV, or the independent variable, is what causes the change in the dependent variable. So in our case, we need to know that caffeine is what actually causes the change in reaction time.